Bringing a vehicle as legendary as an RS500 Ford Sierra to Gran Turismo is kind of a double-edged sword for Polyphony, because on the one hand, it is a car which many of us have wanted in from the series start. This is always that one that stood out for being absent, and along with its little brother, the four-wheel drive advantaged Escort RS with that similar whale tail, these are among the most legendary street-level performance cars here in the UK. With that legendary status, though, comes the double-edged sword of being a high-stakes vehicle. You need this car to be good, but at the same time, you don't want to necessarily make it better than it should be just for the sake of nostalgia. So can this car hold up to the test of time in terms of not just being a nostalgia memberberry collector's piece and be a car that you could actually use? Well, I'm pleased to say absolutely yes. Now, the price tag from the used dealer is 200,000 credits. Sounds about right, really, for what it should be. In real life, these fetch 80, 90, 100 grand, at least here in the UK, used, which is totally understandable, similar to your Audi Quattros, Lancia Deltas, etc. And in terms of performance, by today's standards, it's a little bit weak sauce compared to even a hot hatch. But even as recently as 10, 15 years ago, this was right up there even with stuff like Ford Focus STs and RSs of the time. This thing has 223 horsepower and only weighs a hair over 1,200 kilos. And of course, with a rear-wheel drive chassis, that means it could potentially be quite the weapon, especially when you factor in that the point level is not all that high at 468, so there's plenty of room for tuning, either for cornering and grip focus, or to give it that much more straight line power to keep up with newer machines. Now here at Road Atlanta, of course, which also debuted in 1.26, it can keep up surprisingly well even on the straights with many newer and in many cases far more powerful sports cars, even Vipers and such. That's not exactly realistic. I mean, let's be honest, it's mostly because it's AI, but even then, it does mean that with the AI on the quote-unquote most difficult setting, you could definitely use this thing. Straight out of the box, it's already keeping up with cars like this, and you can make up a lot of ground through corners. So when you tune it, you can most definitely make it that much better. One of the downsides, though, that some people have expressed is that the level of tuning on this car isn't as crazy as you might hope. You're probably hoping for maybe around 600 horsepower potential. These Escort RS blocks and Sierra RS blocks are known for their tuning potential, but this one, you're looking at more like the 400 region. That's not bad, but it's not as high as you might hope. That being said, with only 1,200 kilos to begin with, and of course weight loss options on top, as well as widening the track, lowering it, stiffening the springs, more powerful brakes, and of course the kicker of better tyres, you absolutely can make this thing a weapon. It already is. You can make it into even more of one. Now, overall, I will say that the car is actually a lot better than it easily could have been. This is a vehicle which has been in the Forza franchise for quite some time, and to be honest, it's a car that I don't end up using that much. Partially because there are so many cars in the game to choose from, and also partially because, as I've lamented before, the engine swaps in Forza mean that a lot of cars feel like they're not really necessary, this being one of them. Gran Turismo, I will say, one of the key things that they do well in every Gran Turismo game is that aside from some of the duplicates, most cars do feel pretty unique. And if you're gonna go for something unique, well, a Sierra RS500 is a pretty good one to choose. I would be very, very curious to see how the Escort RS would fare in this game. Similar amount of power, huge advantage of four-wheel drive, and of course more of a rally leaning, whereas this typically is thought of more in the touring car sense, but certainly you could use it as a rally car as well, and some did. It is, however, I think, an excellent example of a car that has arrived in the game after a lot of fanfare for many years from loyal fans who've wanted to see it, especially of course with the E30 M3 being in the game, and although not currently, in the past of the franchise, having the Mercedes 190e Evo as well. Having all three of those back together would make for a fantastic rival showdown. For now though, even just having the Beamer to go up against, as well as everything else in career mode and online events, it's definitely a car you could get a ton of use out of. And at least from what I've seen, the general consensus so far is that people seem pretty happy with this thing. Aside from the maybe slight lack of top-end tuning that some people have griped about, or the fact that it is quite tail-happy, which, let's be honest, being a lightweight 220 horsepower old-school car with rear-wheel drive, well, It's not exactly surprising that it's going to be tail happy, but I actually see this as a very, very good base vehicle to work with for a wide variety of reasons. In fact, this car ticks a lot of boxes. It's got the legendary factor, so of course it pleases a lot of players who have always wanted it, but also it's a fantastic, justified collector's piece. The price isn't too crazy, the point level isn't too crazy, so you can do a lot to it, but also with those touring car and to some degree rally routes, you can use it as a multi-purpose vehicle. You could tune it up to be a straight line machine within a certain power level, say 300-400 horses. You could use it as a track car purely for cornering. Definitely it has more than enough potential there. You could use it as a performance point specific build. You could use it as a rally car as well. There are a ton of different routes that you could take to make this thing great. And the potential is definitely there both on and off road. Or, to speak once again to that tail-happy nature which it inherently has, I could certainly see you building this as kind of a Euro alternative to stuff like your Silvias as a drift build. So, a pretty damn good all-round canvas. Speaking of canvas, it's also a great livery base. It's a pretty nice addition to the game, all things considered. Ultimately though, that's it for my thoughts on the RS500. Of course I'd love to hear yours down below, so drop those comments. Are you happy with the car? Disappointed with it? Is it a car you've wanted for years? Or maybe just something you hadn't even given a second thought and were pleasantly surprised by? And of course, stick around on the channel for my coverage of the other cars in the same update as well. But for now, as always, thanks for watching.